So, Margaret, tell me, what does the funding announcement, the funding for adaptation, where does that need to go in the Global South?
Thank you so much. We are so grateful to Scottish Government for making that pledge. And it is the actions which we want to see. They have shown a very good example, and I urge all the heads of the nations to pick that example. So such funding for climate adaptation and addressing damages should be directed to farmers, the farming community, and the farm organizations like ESAF, Eastern and Southern Africa's Small Scale Farmers Forum, like African Women's Collaborative for Healthy Food System, like Oxfam, which are so passionate about farmers, and they look at ensuring that farmers' voices are heard. So if such funds are directed to such organizations, we are sure as farmers to receive and be able to address the challenges we are facing as effects of climate change in our community, and have healthy food to our family and have healthy population. Thank you.
What role do women play in farming and in adapting to climate change?
Women play a lot of roles. One, they provide labor in agriculture to produce food. It is the effort of women. Now, to address climate change, women are domesticating indigenous seed, which have been neglected, and they are drought resistant, so they bring back those seeds and ensure that they have food in their homes. There are some food crops which have been in the bush, yet they are so nutritious, and it has been helping a lot during crisis. So women are trying to domesticate those seeds and restore the seeds and keep the seeds in the seed bank, so that they can easily share, they can easily have access to, and they plant what they want. They have their groups, farmer groups, in which they share ideas on how they go about with the climate change. They learn from each other and come up with the common solutions to address effects of climate change in the community, in the farming community.